Hello friends, standard 8. Now we are doing exercise 1.2, question number 5. Right? So question number 5, first and second video we done in last video. Okay? Now in this video we are doing question number 5, number 3. Right? 5 and 5 is the numbers between 1 by 4 and 1 by 2. What we will take at first? What we will do at first? We will take LCM of 4 and 2. Right? LCM of 4 and 4 and 2 is what? 4 and 2 2 2 4 2 1 2 and 2 1 2 2 1 2 right so LCM is equal to 4 LCM is equal to 4 so in both denominators we should have 4 so first one is 1 by 4 right so we don't have to touch it then 1 by 2 we will multiply it by 2 to make it to make the denominator 4 so 2 by 4 so between 1 by 4 and 2 by 4 we want 5 as the numbers okay suppose you multiply both the numbers by 6 1 by 4 into 6 into 6 that equal to 6 by 24 and 2 by 4 into 6 into 6 2 by 4 into 6 into 6 that is equal to 12 by 24. So between 6 and 12, between 6 and 12 we have 5 decimal numbers. So we can write here therefore required 5 decimal numbers are decimal numbers R. So after 6, what will come? 7. So 7 by 24, 8 by 24, then 9 by 24, 10 by 24, then 11 by 24, 11 by 24, right? So how many numbers? 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. We want how many? 5 numbers. Between 6 by 24 and 12 by 24, we got 7 by 24, 8 by 24, 9 by 24, 10 by 24, and 11 by 24. What we have done? First, we have taken LCM of 4 and 2. Right? So, LCM of 4 and 2, we got what? 4. Right? Here, 2 2 and 2 1 and again 2 1 and 1. Same. So, 1 by 4 in denominator there is 4 so we don't have to touch it then here 1 by 2 we want what in the denominator 4 so we multiply denominator by 2 so numerator also by 2 so 1 to the 2 upon 2 to the 4 so 1 by 4 into 6 into 6 why because 1 by 4 between 1 by 4 and 2 by 4 we don't have 5 as the numbers so we have multiplied both by 6 So 6 by 24, then again 2 into 6, 4 into 6, so 12 by 24. Between 6 by 24 and 12 by 24, we have 5 decimal numbers. Then write 5 decimal numbers with greater than minus 2, right? So we can write minus 1 and half, right? Then minus 1, then minus half, minus 1 and half, then minus 1. Then minus half, then 0, then half, right? How many are there? 5 are there, right? Then find 10 decimal numbers between 3 by 5 and 3 by 4. So again, we will take LCM. Taking LCM of 5 and 4. 5 and 4 are 2 prime numbers, so their LCM will be about 20. LCM is equal to 20 because they are 4 prime numbers. Okay. There is no common factor of 5 and 4. So they are 4 prime. So we don't have to do like this method. Okay. Directly we can write 5 to the 20. So LCM is 20. So 3 by 5 that is equal to 3 by 5 upon 5 to the again 5 4 12 by 20. Then 3 by 4 that is equal to 3 by 4 into 5 25, so 15 upon 20. Now between 12 and 15, we don't have 10 decimal numbers. So we will multiply both by 10. Or if we multiply by 5, 12 by 20 into 5 into 5, so 60 by 100. Right? Then if you multiply 15 by 5 into 20 into 5, so 75 by 100. So between 60 and 75, we have 10 decimal numbers, right? So you can write required 10 decimal numbers are decimal numbers. After 60, what will come? Up to 60 to 74, we can write. Right? But only 2 we will write. Only 10 we will write. Okay? So, any 10 we can write. 61 by 100, 62 by 100, then 63 by 100, then 64 by 100. Then 65 by 100, then 66 by 100, then 67 by 100, then 68 by 100, then 69 by 100. Right, and after that I can write 74 by 100. 74 by 100. Right, not necessary I write 70 by 100. Right, 70 by 100. So 74 by 100 will be accepted. Right? Any 10 you can write. Okay, I am explaining this again. Find 5 decimal numbers between 1 by 4 and 1 by 2. So what we have done? Their denominators are different, so we have taken LCM of 4 and 2. Right? So 2 1 4, 2 1 4. Again, 2 1 4 and 1 as it is. Right? So 2 1 4 is LCM. Now 1 by 4, in denominator there is 4, so we don't have to do anything to 8. Then 1 by 2, we have to bring 4 in the denominator. So we will multiply it by 2. So 2 to the 4, here also 2. 1 to the 2, 2 by 4. Between 1 by 4, 2 by 4, there are no any 5 decimal numbers. Okay, so we are multiplying both by 6. Why we have taken 6? Because here is 5, so 5 plus 1 is 6. Okay, so 1 6 and 4 6, so 6 by 24, then 2 by 4, so 2 6 and 4 6, so 12 by 24. Okay, so between 6 by 24, 12 by 24, we will have 5 decimal numbers. So required 5 decimal numbers are 7 by 24, 8 by 24, 9 by 24, 10 by 24 and 11 by 24. This is not 12, it is 24. Okay, here it is 24. Okay, make correction. Then write 5 decimal numbers greater than minus 2. Brother, insan sahi karti hoti hai. Maybe insan, right? It may be possible that I can mistake. So insan ki karti hoti aur mil jati hai kabhi ye yahan par karti hai. Right? So write 5 decimal numbers greater than minus 2. So minus 1 and half, minus 1, minus half, 0 and 1 by 2. All these are greater than minus 2. Find 10 decimal numbers between 3 by 5 and 3 by 4. So LCM of 5 and 4 is 5 for the 20, both are 2 prime numbers, right? There is no common factor of 5 and 4. So we can directly multiply for LCM. Now, so we have to bring between denominator 20. So to make 5, 20, we will multiply it by 4. Right? Instead of 5, we will want 20. So 5, 4, 9, 3, 4, that's 12 by 20. Then 3 by 4, so 4, 5, 20. So we will multiply numerator also by 5. So 3, 5, 15, 15 by 20. So between 12 and 15, we don't have 10 decimal numbers. We don't have 10 decimal numbers. Okay. So we are multiplying both by 5 in numerator and denominator. So 12 5 and 25 are 15 5 and 25 are 12 5 61 by 100, 62 by 100, 63 by 100, 64 by 100, 65 by 100, 66 by 100, 67 by 100, 68 by 100, 69 by 100, and 74 by 100. Right, we can write 70 by 100 instead of 69. We can write 72 by 100, 71 by 100 also we can write. Okay, we can remove any one or two from this, and 71, 72, 73 we can write. Right, three numbers we can remove. And so we have to write any 10. Right, we have given 61 to 69, and then one number 74 we have written. So 10 we have written. Okay, after this we will write the main points of this chapter, and then we will start new chapter. Okay, this chapter will be over now, and we will write its main point to remember. Okay, which is written in your textbook. That also we will write in our notebook. Okay, notebook also we will write. Okay, you write down this one. Okay friends, now main points of the chapter we are discussing. What we have learned in this chapter? Decimal numbers are closed under the operations addition, subtraction and multiplication. Right, we have put together the decimal number. Do decimal number add karenge to decimal number aayega, do decimal number subtract karenge to decimal number aayega, and if we multiply to decimal number we will get decimal number. So we can say decimal numbers are closed under operations addition, subtraction and multiplication. They are not okay. The operations additions and multiplication are, and here we are written what they are closed under addition, subtraction and multiplication. They are not closed for what? Division. Right, if we divide two decimal number we can get the decimal number, but it is not necessary because by zero division is not possible. Right, we can't divide zero by any number. So in division we have written addition, subtraction, multiplication, but we have not written division. The operations addition and multiplication are commutative. Right, a plus b is equal to b plus a. Right, in any order we can add two decimal numbers, and multiplication also we can get 2 into 3, that is equal to 3 into 2. In any order we can multiply two decimal numbers. Right, so they are, decimal numbers are commutative under multiplication and addition. Commutative for decimal numbers and associative for decimal numbers. Right, so addition means, and associative means, a plus b plus c, that is equal to a plus b n plus c. Right, and for multiplication what? A cross b cross c, that is equal to a cross in bracket b cross c. Right, that is called associative property. And in commutative what? A plus b is equal to what? B plus a. A cross b is equal to b cross a. That is called commutative, and that is called associative. Okay, the decimal numbers, decimal number 0 is the additive identity for decimal numbers. What is meaning of additive identity? 0 is called additive identity because we can add 0 to any number in any order. If we do 2 plus 0 or 0 plus 2, answer will be 2. So no effect on 2 of 0. So 0 is called additive identity. If you 0 to 2 in a sarpati, नहीं है एडिशन या सबट्रैक्शन में. द रेशनल नंबर 1 इज द मल्टीप्लिकेटिव आइडेंटिटी फॉर रेशनल नंबर्स. इफ यू मल्टीप्लाई एनी नंबर, एनी रेशनल नंबर बाय 1, ओके, आंसर विल बी द अदर नंबर. राइट, सो 1 इज कॉल्ड अ मल्टीप्लिकेटिव आइडेंटिटी. द एडिटिव इनवर्स ऑफ द रेशनल नंबर a बाय b इज माइनस a बाय b एंड वाइस वर्सा. राइट, inverse means only to other side. So additive inverse of a by b is minus a by b, and minus a by b, additive inverse is a by b. Right, vice versa means iska ulta. The reciprocal of multiplicative inverse of the rational number a by b is c by d. If a by b cross c by d is equal to 1, so what is meaning of reciprocal of multiplicative inverse? If we multiply two any numbers and we get answer 1, then that two numbers are called multiplicative inverse or reciprocal. Multiplication of two number
is 1, then those two numbers are called multiplicative inverse of each other, or we can call what the reciprocal of each other. Then distributivity of rational numbers for all the rational numbers a, b and c, a into b plus c, that will be a b plus ac, and a into b minus c, that will be a b minus ac, right? So these all we have done in the chapter. So last two points are left, then we will write down. Okay, understand all of you? Have samajh mein aaya? Ye sab pad chuke ho? All this we have learned in the chapter. Now two points 8 and 9 we will write, then the chapter will be over. Okay, write down. Okay friends, now points number 8 and 9, rational numbers can be represented on the number line on rational numbers of the set, right? Between any two given rational numbers, there are countless rational numbers, right? The idea of mean help us to find rational numbers between two rational numbers. मतलब mean वाला idea से भी हम rational numbers कोई भी दो number के बीच में find कर सकते हैं, right? Suppose we want to find rational numbers between 2 and 3, right? So by idea of mean, how can we can find? So 2 plus 3 by 2, right? These are two numbers, so we will divide it by 2, so 5 by 2, right? So one number is 5 by 2 between these two, right? Between these two also we can find other numbers. Suppose 5 by 2 plus 3 upon 2, right? So 5 plus 3 plus 6 by 2 to the 4, so 11 by 4. So between these two, 11 by 4, right? Between these two also we can find also. So 2 plus 5 by 2 upon 2, 2 to the 4, so 4 plus 5 and 2 to the 4, so 9 by 4 we can write, right? So between these two, 9 by 4 is there. Now between these two also we can find all rational number. So we can write 5 by 2 plus 11 by 4. 5 by 2 plus 11 by 4 upon 2. Now LCM of 2 by 4 is what? 4. So 5 by 2 into 2 into 2 plus 11 by 4 upon 2. Right. So 5 plus 10. 10 plus 11 by 4 to the 8. So 21 by 8. Right. 5 by 2 and 11 by 4. Here will be 21 by 8. 21 by 8. Right. Now between these two also we can find. We can also find numbers. So 9 by 4 plus 5 by 2. 5 2. LCM of 4 into this 4. So we will multiply this by 2. So 9 by 4 plus 5 by 2 into 2 into 2 by 2. In exercises we have not done by this method, right? But by this method also we can find rational numbers. Okay. So 9 by 4, 10 by 4 by 2. Now 9 plus 10 is what? 19 by 8. So 19 by 8 will come here between these two. 19 by 8. Okay. Now between these two also we can find rational numbers, right? So 2 and 9 by 4. 2 plus 9 by 4 upon 2. So 2 4 by 8. 8 plus 9 by 8. So that is equal to 17 by 8. Right. So it will come here. 17 by 8. 17 by 8. So we have found 2, then 17 by 8, then 9 by 4, then 19 by 8, then 5 by 2, then 21 by 8, then 11 by 4 and 3. Okay. So how many numbers we have found? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, case number we have found between 2 and 3 by method of mean. Right? Mean ki method se humne kitne numbers find kiye? 6 numbers we have found. So this method is also valid. Instead of multiplication, we can do also this one. Okay? In exercises we have done multiply and then we have found between numbers. Right? Each mein jo number aayega wo multiplication se find kiye. So aise bhi hum find kar sakte hain. Okay, you write down this method. Okay, this is roughly I have shown. Okay, you write down this, and this is 17 by we have written, which we have found here 17 by. Okay, and our method is started from here 2 plus 3 by 2. 2 plus 3 plus 2, and that is equal to 5 by 2. That I have written here. Okay, whichever middle number we have found, between number we have found, that I have written in that way. Right? This, जो दोनों number के बीच में हमने number find किया है, तो वो दोनों के बीच में मैंने number यहाँ पर लिखा है. जैसे 2 plus 9 by 4 का किया है, तो यहाँ पर लिखा है. 9 by 4 और 5 by 2 के बीच में किया है, तो वो यहाँ पर लिखा है. Right? 5 by 2 और 11 by 4 का जो बीच वाला number find किया है, वो यहाँ लिखा है. Okay? और 11 by 4 और 3 का find नहीं किया. Okay? We can also find that. Okay? So like this way we can also find. This is called mean method, right? Okay, write down this one. And after this we will start next chapter. I think chapter 2 we will start. Okay, write down.